Hi, I'm Dr. Edward Marcaccio. I'm Chief of Vascular Surgery here at South Shore Hospital. And today I wanted to talk to you a little bit about peripheral arterial disease, as it is Peripheral Arterial Disease Awareness Month in September. Peripheral arterial disease is commonly known as hardening of the arteries, and it's a process by which plaque builds up in the arteries all throughout the body, particularly in the arteries to the lower extremities and times to the upper extremities, causing limitation in blood flow to the muscle groups of the extremities and problems with walking. The most common symptoms early on of peripheral arterial disease is cramping in the muscles, usually in the calf muscles, when you walk a certain distance. This cramping gets better when you stop or stand still, and then when you walk that same distance again, the cramping comes back, preventing you from walking further. Common risk factors for peripheral arterial disease are smoking and diabetes. Other risk factors include high blood pressure, elevated cholesterol, and of course, family history. Treatments for peripheral arterial disease, they cover the whole gamut of different approaches. Usually we start with a more conservative approach and generally try to have patients who are having difficulty walking enroll in exercise programs. As you exercise your muscle and begin to walk a distance, it allows you to build up collateral circulation to your leg and also allows the muscle to function more effectively. Interventional techniques to deal with peripheral arterial disease include balloons and stents that you may have heard about, and the more traditional bypass type surgery, which more commonly nowadays is not required. If you're having trouble walking and it's a type of problem that is reproducible, meaning when you walk 100 feet, your leg cramps, start with your primary care physician. They can usually order some non-invasive screening type tests to determine whether your circulation is normal. If it's not normal, they'll send you to someone like a vascular surgeon or at times an interventional cardiologist, and they will go over the different treatment options that I've outlined and get you on the path toward better walking and better cardiovascular health. The most important thing any one of us will tell you, though, is that you have to discontinue tobacco. If you're a smoker, you can't be and still do well with this disease.